Alright, I think we're on. We're on. Alright. Taking a little break from Kingdom Hearts to play what is essentially a depressing interactive novel. I have been waiting for this game to come out for a long time. I gotta get up for work tomorrow, so we're only gonna do like an episode or two. But I really wanted to play this. And I really wanted to share it. So, let's take a look at what remains of Edith Finch. And we're on a boat. Be nice if they told me what button to press.
Isn't going to make sense to you. And I'm sorry about that. I'm just going to start at the beginning with the house.
Real quick, let me make sure that subtitles are on. Interesting, we don't have a subtitles option. Fair enough.
I lived here until I was 11, but I wasn't allowed inside half the rooms.
Oh, interesting. I thought the words would go with the camera, but it doesn't.
Inside the mailbox were bills from 7 years ago, marked urgent, open immediately.
Okay. Can I kneel? No, I can zoom in, that's about it. Okay.
I hadn't been back since my brother Lewis's funeral.
Oh, okay. Wish I had seen that a little better. So, camera monitor.
In her will, my mother left me a key, but didn't tell me what it unlocked. Maybe she thought I'd know. Or she thought that the mystery would be enough to bring me back.
Well, I don't know if I should have taken the up path or the down path. That sign was pretty ambiguous. There's a creek. Well, the narration has stopped. The hell? Okay, these are all missing posters of the same person.
The truth is, even after I inherited the house, I never thought I'd come back to it. But now I had questions about my family that only the house knew the answers to.
And the house can be stingy about that.
The woods around the house have always been uncomfortably silent. As if they're about to say something, but never do.
Well, to be fair, there were a lot of frogs where I was. So there are a lot of missing persons posters lying around. It's all the same person. what the hell is the dragon doing in the lake, or the creek?
The house was exactly like I remembered it, the way I'd been dreaming about it.
That looks like some kind of carnival ride or something. And there are more missing posters all over the place. Okay. Do
As
I go
a
directly?
Child, the house made me uncomfortable in a way I couldn't put into words. Now, as a 17-year-old, I knew exactly what those words were. I was afraid of the house.
I thought she was going to say grody or something like that.
Something moving around in the garage.
Oh wait, I have the key. I don't know if I can bring up my inventory, or I do have a key, but I guess it's not to this door.
Crawling through the doggy door used to be a lot easier when I was 11.
Alright, so this the game doesn't necessarily tell you when you can interact with stuff. Oh my god, they got the tennis ball hanging from the garage roof so you don't bring the car in too far. That's pretty funny. Kitty pool, some bikes.
For the first time in years. I felt like I was home.
A creepy home that terrifies you? Sure, you're home. Tales of tastes and tummies.
But instead of a family, there were just memories of one.
Well, that's not a pleasant little note.
Like how only one restaurant would deliver to our house, so we had Chinese a lot. Or how after Louis started working at the cannery, we all got sick of eating salmon. Except our cat, Molly.
Okay, I'm not exactly sure where I should be going
yet. The table was still a wreck from the night we left. It was like a bomb had gone off, killing everyone but sparing the furniture.
Okay. God, these folks have more books than I do.
My mom was the only one of us who could imagine Great-Grandma Edie living in a nursing home.
I'm getting a real Resident Evil 7 vibe for the early part of this.
Nothing in the house looked abnormal. There was just too much of it, like a smile with too many teeth.
Oh, Arsenio Hall.
Even the fireplace had a story. Edie told me the bricks came from the original house after it sank.
After it sank. These folks liked to cook, or at least to read about cooking.
Mom always told me to stay out of the basement, so I wasn't too surprised when the key didn't fit.
Mama always said life was like a box of chocolates.
Great-grandpa Sven built a music box for Barbara, along with the rest of the house.
Okay, that's a Sasquatch behind the little girl dancing in the woods. Barbara Finch was an actress? An actress. Okay. There's the front door. This was the way to the kitchen, right? Okay. I keep seeing pieces of light that I think are shinies. What the hell?
Edie told me once that every Finch who ever lived is buried somewhere in the library.
Wow, that's like foam insulation around the door. Jesus. Okay, I can't go in the basement yet, so...
After Milton disappeared, Mom sealed up all the bedrooms. Then Edie retaliated and drilled peepholes.
Jeez. Okay. What?
I spent a lot of time playing in Great Uncle Walter's room. Lewis told me there were secret passages, but I never believed him.
Okay.
Turns out, my mom was really good at keeping secrets. Now it was time to find out what my mom had been afraid of.
Okay, I wanna... That's fucking cool. I would have had great white sharks in my bedroom, but that's fucking cool. Alright, that looks a little too conspicuous, but let's go through here first.
Reading this, maybe it sounds like I had a plan. But I had no idea what was behind that door. Just like I had no idea where all this was gonna lead.
I am not getting a happy feeling from this.
I grew up looking at Molly's room through the peephole.
Oh. I thought maybe they wanted me to look through the peephole.
Molly's gerbil had a tiny bedroom with its own even tinier gerbil cage. Being inside for the first time, I felt like I'd stepped behind a painting.
That's not even remotely creepy.
Wow.
December 13th, 1947. Dear Diary, I'll be gone soon, but I wanted to tell somebody about what's gonna happen. It started when Mom sent me to bed without dinner. I woke up and I was starving, so I looked around for something to eat.
Oh, she's not gonna eat gerbil food, is she? Or the gerbil itself?
My Halloween candy was all gone. The gerbil food was dry, but I didn't mind it.
Jesus. Oh no, don't eat your fish, kid, please.
I thought about eating Christopher, but I held back.
Oh, okay, she climbed up there. That's why the control got all wacky.
I kept eating and eating.
You know what I didn't even realize until now is the, wow. The perspective is she's much shorter than Edith. It was actually throwing me off.
I ate a lot of things that night.
Wow, her hands are like spotted. No, we're not gonna go there.
Then I heard chirping outside my window. It was a barn swallow going back to her nest. I reached out for her.
Okay, this is...
And suddenly... I was a cat!
I'm the worst cat ever.
I tried to be quiet, but the bird was really scared.
Can I make that? Okay, yeah, I can. Dagnabbit bird. You're leading me on a merry chase. Okay, I made it here, but I'm not supposed to be here. I'm not gonna make that jump, though. Can I climb up here? No? I'm not sure what they want me to do here. Never mind.
Mom and Dad didn't even look at me.
Oh, Well, Mom and Dad didn't look like they were having too great a time, kid.
I jumped and I almost got her. I could tell she was getting really tired.
Just looking around. Oh, I'll get you.
Now I was up in the big tree. I promised Dad I wouldn't climb it anymore. All I cared about was eating that mama bird.
Yeah.
I gobbled her up.
Oh!
And suddenly, I was an owl. First, all I heard was the wind. Then I heard little teeth nibbling in the grass.
Okay, this I'm not controlling. Okay.
Rabbits.
Wabbits. Yeah, but I'm no better at catching rabbits than they were. I was at catching mice. I mean, birds. Like, I can't. Oh, there we go. I couldn't quit. Oh, hey, got him.
I imagined his face looking up and seeing mine through my talons. I swallowed him up, and I didn't chew one bit. Then I flew off to find something bigger.
You're not full?
A rabbit.
What? Oh, a mama rabbit. Okay.
She was almost too big to carry. I started choking, but I couldn't stop eating. And suddenly, I was a shark.
Okay. Okay, we can do this.
I rolled off the cliff and into the ocean.
Look, I could buy a fucking car.
Now, I was hungrier than ever.
Oh, hello, fish.
I wanted fat, juicy seals.
Oops, this control's a little wacky. Okay. Well, dude, you don't just tear off the flipper. Okay, there she is.
Everything had changed.
I'm a fucking octopus tentacle.
Now I was a monster and I smelled people everywhere.
I can't retract this tentacle. I don't know what to do. Okay. Can I go under a car? Okay, yeah, I can.
I was big, but I moved real quiet.
Okay, this game has taken a turn for the bizarre. I like it, but it's taken
a turn. But also, I didn't.
I think I need to go outside to get that last guy.
Smell went into an old pipe.
A sewer pipe, of course. And a Dufresne crawled through a pipe full of shit smell and grossness. Oh my god, I really did go through the toilet.
I got closer and closer.
Oh, this is gonna be a kid. This is her bedroom.
All my stomach started growling. And suddenly, I was me again. I held my breath for a long time, but I couldn't hear anything. I think it's waiting for me to fall asleep. But it's not going to wait much longer. It needs to be, and we both know. I will be delicious.
I'm not sure if I believed all of that, but I'm sure Edie would have.
Okay, I'm sorry, that took a minute for me to digest.
I got the sense Edie had spent a lot of time here before my mom sealed the doors.
This will be obvious later, but my mom never told me any of these stories. Edie would have, but Mom didn't like bringing up the past. Though, when we adopted a stray kitten, she was the one who named it Molly. I spent a lot of time in Great-Grandma Edie's room.
Okay. Oxygen. Paintings. CRT TV and VCR tapes.
Edie gave a big interview about a mole man living under the Finch house. My mom was furious. I hadn't thought of myself as Edith Jr. for a long, long time.
My friend Bigfoot? Random junk? Weird America?
One summer, they evacuated the island, but Edie refused to go. For a few weeks, she was a celebrity.
A celebrity kook. Any video game console? I'm sorry, I don't...
People, Sven was killed by a dragon. She could also have said he was building a dragon-shaped slide that collapsed. She could have, but she didn't.
Okay, so now we know what that thing was in the, in the creek.
Even in her 90s, sometimes Edie seemed a lot younger than my mother.
Oh, in the room. No, I don't think Edie was a big gamer.
The room is like a museum.
Oh, Viewmaster.
For 500 years, the Finches have been famous throughout Norway for their fortune and misfortune.
Wait, what? That's it? Just the one? They're not going to let me click around? There we go.
Odin Finch buries the latest victims of the family curse. His wife, Ingeborg, and their newborn son, Johan. On January 7th, 1937, he set sail with his family and his house, hoping to leave the curse behind.
Oh, that's what she meant. Yeah, I did too.
But 40-foot waves off the coast of Washington send the house and Odin to the bottom of the sea.
Yeah, this was the not-so-successful
Odin's
prequel to Up.
Katie, with husband Sven and baby Molly, step ashore on their new home, Orcas Island. Odin Finch is the first to be buried in the new family cemetery. His daughter Edie is already dreaming of a new Finch house. Whatever's wrong with this family, it goes back a long ways.
Okay. The devil's flame in the water black, the old breed, oh. Yeah, no. I later on, they did do electronic Viewmasters that did have, like, audio with them. Okay. What the hell? All right, yes.
The only trace Grandpa Sam's first wife, Kay, left on the house was the pink bathroom. It was a pretty big trace.
Yeah. It looks like the Martian tentacles from War of the Worlds. Uh-oh.
There's a secret in this bathroom. It's in the last place you would look. It isn't in the cupboard. It's hidden in this book.
Okay, this is getting very Resident Evil locks.
Sven gave Sam an old camera he'd refurbished. He never put it down. From the paintings on the wall, it was clear my brother Milton had been here before me.
Speaking of which, is this Milton's room? Captured. What's with the rope? Fort Calvin?
I knew Grandpa Sam had a twin. And that he never talked about him.
Oh, there's a stairway to nowhere.
I guess my grandpa didn't like history any more than my mom did.
Oh my god, it's Spaceman Spiff's helmet.
How I Want to Remember My Brother by Sam Finch. The thing I remember is that when he made up his mind, that was it.
That's a broken leg. Or at least a broken foot.
My brother said he'd die before he ate another mushroom. And he did. At Barbara's funeral, we swore we'd never be afraid again. And he wasn't.
Okay, he's got a broken foot.
I think Calvin always wanted to fly.
Sam! Calvin! Dina's ready! Coming!
But that day, he finally made up his mind to do it.
No.
I told him going around was impossible.
Oh, man. No. This swing is way too close to the edge of that cliff.
Maybe if I hadn't said that. Maybe if the wind hadn't picked up.
Alvin, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Then maybe I'd still be here. But I doubt.
Probably. I got a bad feeling it's not going to do good for Calvin.
That's what I want to remember about my brother. The day he made it was mine to fly. And he did.
A fly, he did. Land? Not so much.
Calvin's story felt strangely familiar. When I was younger, I remember trying to do the exact same thing.
Yeah, but you can't get anywhere near that way because of inertia. So there's something. There's either something really wacky there, or it's a complete bullshit. Okay.
After the funeral, Edie roped off Calvin's half of the room.
Oh, I do not like the frowny face I'm seeing down that passageway. Let me take a quick look and make sure I didn't miss anything in the room.
Mom said Grandpa Sam enlisted at 18 and never set foot in the room again.
That's funny, I didn't see that. Okay. I don't think I missed anything. It's certainly,
The passages were a pretty tight fit. They'd obviously been built for smaller hands and bellies.
Well, do I want to go there first, or do I want to go to Frowny Face first? I guess we'll go here first. Probably leads to the same place
Growing
anyway.
Up, I always thought of Barbara as a child star.
Oh, she starred in Harry and the Hendersons. Wow. A couple of awards. One of the other rooms I could look through a peephole.
I never thought about how hard it must have been for her afterwards. Of all the stories people wrote about Barbara's death, I'm surprised Edie saved this one.
Oh, this is some creep show shit right here.
Jack here with another ghastly tale inspired by America's most unfortunate family. I'm calling it the surprise ending of
Nice crypt keeper impression.
As a child star, Barbara was famous for her scream. Now at 16, she was all washed up. A has-been. But in a lucky break, she'd been asked to perform her signature scream at a local convention for monster movie fans. It was just the boost her career needed.
Yeah, not so much.
Her scream hadn't aged well.
Getting better. I think you just need the right motivation.
Her biggest fan and current boyfriend.
Oh no.
Rick was about to demonstrate when.
Now that was a great scream.
It was Barbara's father, Sven. He'd slipped into a table saw and had to be rushed to the emergency room. So Barbara got stuck babysitting her youngest brother, Walter. Her convention comeback was cancelled.
Oh, what?
Okay,
Walter couldn't
I'm
go to the hospital with that?
But I'm not hearing terror. What if I tried...
A gang of hoodlums in Halloween masks have been terrorizing Orca's Island tonight. Police are urging residents to...
That came from the basement.
You're right. Also, I loved your delivery on that. Why is your basement door locked?
Because my dad likes making puzzles and secret passages. There's a key okay. in the music box. The secret is
Ooh.
Winding and winding until finally the key pops out.
Thanks, babe.
I'll be back in a second.
20 minutes later, Rick hadn't returned. So Barbara went to look for him, right on cue. She reached for the music box. And as she wound the key, she listened for Rick, but the house was silent.
No, we saw that music box downstairs earlier. Uh-oh. Get the fuck out. They're playing the Halloween music.
She found Rick's crutch and imagined the worst.
I can't believe they're playing the Halloween music. This is so cool. Stupid beer cans.
The gang's leader is the infamous Hookman Killer, Dr. Carl Hamill, who impaled and then ate his family 10 years ago tonight.
The Hookman Killer. Oh, there's the table saw. Oh, should I hit him?
Oh. Rick?
Barb, relax.
This game is fucking great already.
To help you find your scream.
Well, I'm not scared, Rick. I'm furious.
Then act furious. All I'm getting from you now is that you're hurt and confused.
And you're wondering why you're going out with this asshole.
Throw him out.
You're welcome, Terminator. I'm glad you liked it, man. And if it helped you buy this
Barb,
game, then I'm even more happy.
See my other crutch?
And she was still holding it.
You see my other crutch?
Watching the late, late picture show. Hours later.
Barbara! Walter, what's going on up there? Ah! Okay, I'm coming up. But if this is a trick, you're dead, Walter.
Oh, I thought that was a ladder. You know, if your family home is like cursed and everything, maybe you shouldn't decorate it so well for Halloween. Yep, thanks again. I appreciate you watching. Have a good night and hope you enjoy this game. I certainly am. I am still clutching this. Oh no, I can't not look.
Vanished, but his bedside radio was still on.
Orcas Island police described the man as 6 feet tall, with a steel hook for a hand. Residents are urged to lock all doors and windows and notify the police of any suspicious activity.
Barbara turned, saw the hook man, and was speechless. He was quite smashing.
Snicked.
He couldn't get enough of Barbara.
Okay, Barbara. There's gotta be another way out of here.
That night, she played her part beautifully.
Oh, I'm gonna club this fool in the back of the head if I get the chance. Which way should I go? Nope. Oh, thanks, man. I appreciate it. I'm MST3KNJ on YouTube. I have about 800 videos. All, most of them are LPs. I got to club this ass. Oh! I bet you this is her stupid ex-boyfriend.
But she sensed the story might not be over yet.
Okay, wait. This is a little disconcerting. Okay, there we go. Barbara needs to learn how to run.
Listened for his breathing, but all she heard.
Wait a minute. Is that one of the chairs from Men in Black? What the fuck is that doing here? Oh, it's 12 midnight. I'm coming.
Was dying to speak to young Barbara. at the door. She heard whispering. It was coming from inside the house.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
Surprise!
You are wonderful.
The monsters had come to surprise her. For Barbara, it was a dream come true.
Wait, are they real monsters?
She saw what kind of monsters they were, and she realized what was about to happen. She was going to be famous. And with her final breath, Barbara Finch gave the performance of her life. I wasn't there myself, but I hear Barbara was magnificent.
Succulent, even?
She had a taste for stardom. But unfortunately, so did her fans. Of course, the police blamed it all on poor Rick, who disappeared the same night. And little Walter, hiding under his bed the whole time.
He spent the rest of his life in therapy.
That's another story. As for Barbara, tucked inside the music box is all they ever found of her. Her ear. Now that's what I call a real eerie tale.
Oh, Jesus wept, really? Well, that was fucking awesome.
Edie told me all Barbara wanted was to be remembered, as absurd as that comic was. Maybe what Edie saw was a happy ending.
Yeah, sure. Killed by monsters. Totally happy. When I'm not streaming this, I'm going to have to take a look around a little more in depth.
I guess now I know why Mom didn't like me playing with the music box.
Yeah, no kidding.
Whenever people ask me about my family, the first thing they always want to know about is Barbara.
Poor Barbara, who got just eaten by monsters, apparently.
Barbara was a child star for 2 years, until America grew out of it. Edie's father, Odin, built the original house.
And sank it into the ocean, from what I heard.
Mom must have locked the third floor stairs on the night we left.
Well, we know how to get to the basement.
All those times I played with the music box and never found the basement key.
I'm just gonna look through all these peepholes real quick.
As a kid, I just assumed every house had peepholes and sealed rooms you weren't allowed inside of.
Why would you have a peephole in the bathroom?
My Grandpa Sam spent 7 years sharing a room with his dead brother, Calvin.
Okay, obviously I was supposed to do this before I found the way in.
Molly always seemed like a girl I could imagine being friends with, if she hadn't died in 1947.
Okay, so I got all the rooms here. Let's head down to the basement.
Hey,
Why is it going backwards? Because I was going too fast. You're telling me that big fucking white thing is not something I can look at? You gotta be shitting me. Okay, this basement is not finished. Oh, are we gonna find the saw? Oh no, there it is. Oh no. Wow, nothing to see though.
Mom said the basement was off limits, unless I wanted another tetanus shot. I saw Edie sneak down to the basement once, carrying packages. I thought maybe she was hiding presents.
Did you follow her down here?
It turned out she was hiding a lot more than that.
What? Is there a generator going or something?
I remember asking Mom once about where Walter had gone. She said after Barbara died, he got as far away as he could.
Smart kid.
If there's a pattern in all these stories...
Is this a bomb shelter?
I think it's that none of us has gotten very far.
Holy shit.
Goodbye, everyone. I can't believe I've been down here for 30 years. On that first day, after the shaking started, I didn't think I'd survive it either. But after a few days, I settled into a routine. That's what kept me sane.
Okay.
Having a schedule, living for today. I always expected to be dead tomorrow.
Well, did he think that there was a nuclear war or something?
If you wait long enough, you'd be used to anything. Even a monster on the other side of the door starts to feel normal.
This is getting 10 Cloverfield Laney.
And then one day, everything just stopped. Whatever that thing was, it was gone. Maybe it got tired of waiting. Or maybe I just got tired of being afraid.
Maybe you got tired of eating peaches.
It's been a week now, the longest in 30 years. I'm done waiting. I have to leave while I still can.
Okay, they're not even letting me walk past here, so.
I know it's out there, somewhere. Whatever killed Barbara.
What?
And Molly.
Oh, okay.
And Calvin.
Wait, I thought this was Calvin.
Maybe this is all a mistake. But I need to stop living the same day. Even if it kills me.
I don't think I could have possibly missed anything in there, so...
Whatever's out there, I want you to know, I'm ready for it.
I got a sledgehammer.
I'm going to appreciate all of it, especially the food. I don't mind if I only have a year left. Or a month. Or a single week.
Oh, God, please don't let him get hit by a train.
One new day. I can already imagine the sun on my face.
This is like a series of unfortunate events, but really depressing unfortunate events.
Six. I can't believe my mom never told me he was down here. I'm sure my mom was trying to protect me.
Hopefully she knows a little more of the train schedule.
Maybe she was afraid I'd end up like Walter. But if she never told me about an uncle under the house...
What else did she tell
her? I can only imagine what else she was hiding. I don't want to make the same mistakes she made.
I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything.
Trying to bury something that's still alive.
All right, Edith, let's
now
just move.
There's only one of us left. Or maybe two. I thought it was time I heard the stories for myself. And found out what happened to everyone else. But now I'm worried the stories themselves might be the problem. Maybe we believed so much in a family curse, we made it real.
Yeah, that's a distinct possibility, Edith. Wait, the train no longer exists?
I don't know if I should even be riding this. Maybe it'd be better if all this just died with me. But I thought you should know about your family.
Oh no, she's preggers.
And the history you're a part of.
Edith, don't you go walk into the ocean. That's pretty. That's a pretty fucking picture right there. Alright, let's just go up the stairs and try to keep Edith from walking into the ocean, shall we?
Though to be honest, I feel as lost as you probably do right now. I think the people in these stories believed them, for what that's worth. you look at the house, at that history of imagination and stubbornness and madness, any of it seems possible.
Oh, I don't have a jump button, so I don't know where I'm supposed to go yet.
I think we've been surrounded by death for so long, we've just gotten used to it. What kind of family finishes building a cemetery before starting the house?
Don't like how high up we are right now. Edith doesn't seem too pleased.
It's embarrassing for me to admit this, but... the pet cemetery made me more uncomfortable.
Bury something in here, it's going to come back from the dead. Jesus.
Three of the gerbils were mine, and two had been my fault.
Chirpy, Burpy, Derpy, and Derpy Jr.
Sven built the house, but it was Edie who designed the cemetery. I'm sure Odin's monument had been Edie's idea. My mom was always trying to move on, but for Edie, the past never went away.
Man always goes down with his house.
She could see it poking out of the water at low tide.
Oh my god, the old house is still out there. Oh my god.
Edie said she dreamed about the old house every night.
There doesn't appear to be anywhere else to go here. Oh, I don't like how fucking far she close she is to the edge. All right, Edie, back off.
Edie's side Edith. Was always easier for me to understand.
That's right, because she's Edith
but
Jr.
But the older I get, the more I can see where my mom was coming from. Her dad had been pretty strict, but it wasn't enough to save her brothers. She was just trying to do better. She lost two of her brothers, just like I did. I get why she tried so hard to protect us. We never found Milton's body, so my mom insisted we were putting up a monument, not a tombstone.
Ay, ay, ay.
There's so many things I wish I could ask my mom now. Part of me thinks this is what she wanted all along. For me to come back someday. And find everything out for myself.
Better find out we were adopted.
But looking back on it now, if she told me there was going to be so much climbing, I never would have come when I was 22 weeks pregnant.
Yep. Can I get in here? No.
I never met Grandpa Sam, but I think he and my mom had a lot in common.
Yeah, they were all loonies.
They were both pretty intense.
All right,
Sam spent
the...
his life shooting photos, but Mom said he got nervous being in front of the camera. I guess we're all afraid of something.
That's a conspicuous door. Let me look around before I pick up that journal entry.
Instead of hiding from death, Sam seemed to go out of his way to meet it.
Or at least dish it out to unsuspecting animals. This room is sealed too.
Dawn, I promise, you'll never forget this weekend.
Yes, sir.
These memories are going to last a lifetime.
Am I going to have to shoot anything?
It's a hunting trip, Dawn. Shooting is strongly encouraged.
What?
Perfect.
Studious as ever.
It's going to rain the whole weekend, isn't it? I will never forget this weekend, Dad.
That's the spirit.
Okay, got it.
I'm gonna take some pictures, okay?
Just be careful. The camera's older than you are.
You're right, Dad. It's starting to clear up. Still freezing, though.
Aw.
Not sure what is. Oh, tell me there's like a Loch Ness monster I can take a picture of. Wait, where's Dad?
Definitely should not have drunk all that coffee.
Oh no.
Hey!
That's a keeper.
I'm just saying, I'm not always gonna be here, Don. You'll need to remember this stuff if you wanna survive.
I'll be fine, Dad.
You know who else thought he was going to be fine?
Some guy who died.
Dawn, I'm being serious.
I know, Dad. You're always serious. Doesn't being out here make you want to chill out?
Well, to tell you the truth, I haven't been out here in 20 years.
And I haven't chilled out in 40.
Last time I was gone, don't you think you could find something more interesting to photograph? Grandpa Sven taught us how to fish, how to build a fire. I found an old logging trail. There were deer everywhere.
Oh, it'd be great if I found a picture of Bigfoot.
I bet if I could remember where that...
Dad!
Good eyes, Dawn. Before you take the shot, let me get a picture of you.
Dad, I...
Just breathe.
She can't kill a deer.
Do I have to do this?
Dawn, you don't have to do anything. But if you want to survive, you'll need to be strong. Now keep yourself squared up, elbows down, like we practiced, whenever you're ready. Great shot, Don.
I commemorated it in film.
I'm proud of you, Don. Always remember that, okay? Sorry, Don. Just gotta reset the timer.
Didn't understand what the hell I was supposed to do there.
Dad, it's twitching. I think
that's
it's
totally
silly.
Normal, Don. Just focus on the camera. Try not to think about
Dad!
Oh, I did not see that coming. Jesus.
Of all these stories, that's the one I wish most that my mom had told me.
Wow. That was fucked up. Yeah, that's some hardware in there.
After Sam died, my mom and Edie got really close. They'd both lost a lot.
Oh, that's just not... Oh, man. This is gonna suck.
Dear Kay, do you remember the way Gregory used to laugh when he thought he was alone? Like something funny was happening, but only he could see it.
That's called dementia. Excuse me. Yeah, I just almost choked. Sorry.
I think there's some things the rest of us don't.
How am I controlling the duck?
Sweetie.
Oh no.
Hello? Sam, I told you I don't want to talk right now.
I wonder what he saw. What his world was like.
Yeah, I got a seriously bad feeling about this.
Lost in his imagination. Whatever it was, he saw.
I am controlling this frog, by the way. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing here. Why is there a ball in here now?
It sure made him happy.
Pretty soon we're going to have enough stuff in here to, oh, I see. I'm supposed to be... I think I'm supposed to be... There we go.
I know how silly it sounds. But I worry about a baby being too happy.
Yeah, no, I don't want... Oh, no. Okay, that water is going really high, really fast.
There's so much I don't understand about Gregory. About everything.
Okay, we gotta be able to pull this plug. Like, seriously.
I'm sure it's happy.
No, not down the drain. No.
Be happy to. Good luck, Kay. Love, Sam.
Well, that was terrible.
I can't imagine my mom ever writing poetry, and yet...
I can't imagine Gus having a mohawk.
A poem for Gus, who always said the wedding was a bad idea. Our father never hit us kids, at least not very hard, before the day my brother said with teenage disregard that he'd be dead before he'd see a wedding in our yard. My father made him come, of course, but Gus stood far apart, just flew his kite and bottled up the storm inside his heart. I tried to talk him out of it, but though he'd never met her, we don't need a stepmom, were the words that
I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Can I dive the kite into the ceremony? No, I will end this. Oh, there we go.
When the time for photos came, Dad ordered him to
come here.
But Gus declined, and as a sign, held up his middle finger.
Oh, you think he's gonna get struck by lightning?
The wind picked up, and panicked geese appeared and quickly went. But all the humans did that day was go inside the tent.
It's starting to get cloudy. Oh no, I think you might be right in, Parka. There they are. Oh, it's like Katamari Damacy.
The rain came down in buckets then, but no one seemed afraid that nature might destroy the tent our dad had crudely made. The thunder sounded much too close and full of angry power. But all my father said to this was, "Make the music louder."
Oh God, what if it's like a tornado and it sucks him up? Uh-oh. Oh no!
I wish that I could truly say I thought about you on that day. Out there on the beach alone, just you, the wind, the sea and foam. But I didn't. Until we found you.
Okay, that was a little vague.
She never talked about him, but Mom told me once if I was a boy, they were going to name me Gus.
And never let you fly a kite. God, they love foaming these doors shut in this house. Oh, I can climb this.
My mom moved up to the loft after her brothers died. At the time, it was as far away as she could get. She spent a summer building houses in Calcutta, where she met my dad. Sanjay.
That explains the Indian names, the West Indian names in the graveyard.
My mom moved to India a week after graduation and got a job teaching English. Louis was born a year later.
Who are all these Oh, that, maybe it's Louis. Oh no, it's Milton. Durr, I should...
When my dad died, I don't think Mom knew where else to go. I'm sure Edie was happy to have her back. The house had to get a little bigger, but Edie was used to that. And for a while... things were good. Almost normal.
I don't think anything in this house could ever be misconstrued as normal.
But it didn't last. The beginning of the end was Milton's 10th birthday, when Edie gave him a castle. After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings. Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Copyright 1952. From what I saw, there's a Jenny running. A generator, sorry. God, I used to make these things as a kid all the time. Little flipbooks. That's weird. This is the first real dead end I've run into in the game.
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
Can I open the door? No, I gotta go out the window again.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
Oh, son of a bitch. Why put that there? I get, oh, okay, I guess to steer you toward the window on your when you first got here. All right, fair enough. Wow, what cover design. I never even would have thought to have looked up here.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Lewis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery. Everyone always told me to stay out of Lewis's room. Except Lewis.
This is a boat in the middle of a big tree. Okay. There we go.
Lewis's room smelled very, very familiar.
No, don't. That I didn't do that. God damn it. It smelled like bong water, apparently. No! Oh my god, I keep turning left to see what's on the wall there, and I keep walking the fuck out the door. Hey, the Wonderland Turbo!
Lewis and I spent a lot of time playing games together, but he was surprisingly bad at them. He died a lot.
Everyone in this family seems to die a lot, Edith.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Lewis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January. Shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Lewis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery. But he withdrew part of himself.
This is a job?
In our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to...
wander. I got a bad feeling about that hand.
Wonder.
Oh, wow. Okay. I gotta control this with one fucking hand. Oh, wow. Okay, this is kind of weird. This is getting kind of brothers on me.
I asked him to describe it. He said he started small, imagining a labyrinth. He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Bats. And toads. And things that have not names.
Oh, Voldemort.
He knew it was all in his head. But he took it very seriously. I had hoped he'd find himself.
This is so weird. I'm controlling the character with my left stick, but I'm still doing the fish with the right stick.
I worry.
Oh, now it's gotten like 3D.
Daydreaming at the cannery. I spoke with his boss.
Oh, wow, this
is... He said Lewis had become a model employee. Methodical, tireless, focused.
This is
new Lewis.
So bizarre.
So I let him go on. I even encouraged him.
I got a bad feeling about my hand. Look how big it's getting.
He told me he'd made a new friend.
It's gonna start covering up everything.
On the edge of a city he named Lewis Topia.
Okay, and name that dummy really does deserve
to lose
hand.
Brick by brick. Then he made musicians. Songs for them to play.
This is the Ballad of the Dead Fish.
And he was always humming something. Every day his imagination grew stronger.
What the hell?
He no longer spoke at the cannery. But his chopping was as reliable as ever. Then one day it struck him that all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, were all in his imagination. So he could do whatever he wished.
Oh, he's gonna become a monster.
He held an election for mayor.
Of course he won.
And he won.
Oh, that is some nice Mario stuff right there.
His mind was already wandering.
Why would he win mayorship and then leave?
It became a game for him.
Come on. Oh, shit.
He'd conquer a city, then immediately push on. New Lewisville. St. Louis. He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis. Until one day he forgot to go home from the cannery. Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Lewis kept sailing on. In Lewisburg, he heard rumors of a... handsome queen. Queen was on her own quest for...
Come on, get in there. I want sinister serpents.
Sinister serpents. He followed the sound of her. Silver harp. His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon. Even then, his logic remained sound.
Hey, don't run away!
He knew the world was all in his imagination.
Oh no. Stop giving me more fish!
He was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. For someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming. And then it struck him that the real Lewis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace.
And you're a trained psychologist.
My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. It was hard to argue with him.
This looks like a fishmonger place to me.
He began to forget the world we know.
Oh, this looks miserable.
I think it pained him to remember Lewis, the cannery worker. He began to despise the man with a royal contempt.
I guess I'm going up here.
I still thought I could save him. Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder. The palace would be packed with his companions. Calico had insisted on inviting him.
Okay.
His queen waited, holding his crown.
Queen's gonna be a fish.
There was only one thing left to do.
Tap that ass.
Bend down his head.
Oh no! Dude, don't you know a guillotine when you see one?
And the rest I think you know. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.
So the only one I'm missing is Calvin. I mean, Dawn, excuse me. Which is her mother. Yeah, they'll let me go up here. Now, that's why they wouldn't let me. That's why I kept, like, going out the door instead of turning left.
On the way back from Lewis's funeral, my mom told me to start packing. She waited until the day before we left to tell Edie. I'm not sure if she wanted to make it easier or harder. I wish we'd stayed. But I understand why we left.
More stairs going up. I'm pretty sure everyone is dead. Even Milton, who just disappeared, is probably dead.
My mom ended up leaving everything behind. What happened that night had been coming for a long time. Maybe it should have come sooner. But it had to end one way or another. All that's left now is to tell you about that last night. That whole last day, Edie just watched us pack and didn't say a word. Until supper, when she raised her glass and said,
"To die, you ungrateful wretches.
Our final night together, and all our final nights apart."
Grandma, you know what I said about alcohol. Some of your medications are very specific.
I left a present for you in the hallway. Why don't you go open it? The grown-ups have to arm you now.
I'm sorry, you're right. We're all leaving tomorrow. Let's just enjoy our last...
I'm not leaving.
Edith, you're excused.
The power had been shut off that morning, but Edie always had plenty of candles. When my mom sealed the library, I don't think she knew about the other entrance. Or that Edie had a key to it.
Now she's pregnant. I doubt that's gonna be the case. I hope not. Jesus, I'll need friggin' Thorazine after this
thing
game.
You're afraid of isn't going to end when you leave the house. Edith has a right to know these stories.
My children are dead because of your stories. I think it's best if Edith and I leave tonight. We'll have the nursing home send a van for you in the morning. Okay?
Jesus.
Dear Edith, there's so many stories I wish I could tell you, but there's only time for one. This is about what happened on the night you were born. That night, the tide went way, way out.
Is she going to be able to walk to the house?
It was the first and last time I ever saw the old house aground. There'd been an earthquake out in the middle of the ocean. They called it the lowest tide in 1,000 years. God, it smelled awful. You know, I've seen that house every day of my life. I never thought I'd go back to it. When the fog rolled in, I lost my way. I got turned around.
Bonk.
For a while, I wandered.
I wander.
I started seeing things.
Stephen King,
things
The Mist.
I'd forgotten had ever existed. But when I saw them, they felt like old friends. That night, a lot of things came back to me. Or maybe I came back to them. Things I can't explain, but that I need you to try and...
Edith, what are you doing in here? It's mine. Edith! Mom, you're gonna rip it! Let go!
I kicked and screamed, but Mom dragged me to the car. I never saw Great-Grandma Edie again. The next morning, the van came to pick her up, but she was already gone.
Gone dead or gone disappeared?
After that, we moved around a lot. We both tried to make the best of it.
Yeah, because her mom's gotta die too. Dawn.
A few years went by. My mom didn't like to talk about it. But she started getting sick a lot. The rest happened pretty quickly.
Oh, boy. Oh, Jesus Christ.
She got better for a while. And then she didn't.
Then she called me Star Lord and I ran away.
And then I was alone. The last Finch left alive. Until I found out about you.
Well, you weren't alone, obviously, because somebody knocked you up.
I'm still not sure to tell you about all this. If we lived forever, maybe we'd have time to understand things. But as it is, I think the best we can do is try to open our eyes and appreciate how strange and brief all of this is.
Oh, we're actually getting born. This is like a birth canal.
This journal was supposed to be for you. But now I hope you'll never see it. I just want to meet you and tell you all these stories myself. But I guess if you're reading this now, things didn't work out that way.
Oh, fuck. If she dies during childbirth, I'm not going to be happy. Like, this game's depressing enough. You don't
this
have to kill
Edith. This is where your story begins. I'm
and
sorry
mine
I won't
ends.
Be there to see it. It's a lot to ask, but I don't want you to be sad that I'm gone. I want you to be amazed that any of us ever had a chance to be here at all. Good luck.
No happy ending. No, of course not. A depressing story by Giant Sparrow. Sorry, Imparka. I swear the next game I play won't be this depressing. Wow, so that's what remains of Edith Finch. Whew. Trophy earned, everything ends. Thanks, game. Look, this is an incredible little game. Like, it's fucking awesome. I love it. But man, is it depressing. It's a really well-told story. Yeah, go hug a loved one. Like, go tell your mom you love her, you know? Christ. But what an imaginative and well-told little story. Even if it was goddamn depressing. Trophy earned, thanks, Johan. Okay. As always, we're going to run the credits, obviously. So there's not much else to say about this. It's very inventive. It keeps throwing. Yeah, and Parker, thank you for watching. I really do appreciate it. MST3KNJ on YouTube. If you like what you saw, I got 800 videos, tons of LPs. And, I appreciate you sticking around. Try to cheer up. Have a good night. Oofa. It's like 2:30 in the morning, isn't it? Oh, goody. I got to get up in 4.5 hours. Oh, the whale shark room was cool, too. God, even... this is just really... fuck. Depressing. Like, it makes you think, obviously. And, it, you know... again, so many, it's like different ways to play. Like, they kept it very fresh. Even if the outcome was always horrible death. Hey, guys, that's a corded phone on a wall. But I mean, like Gone Home, and I will eventually stream Gone Home. This is much more of an interactive, hey, there's your not SNES pad. Like Gone Home, it's not, you know, the destination, it's the journey. And, like Gone Home, it's a very, very well-told story. I've been waiting for this game to come out a long time, too. I just didn't know it would depress me so much. We're going to have to play a really fun game. I don't even know if I'm going to go back to Kingdom Hearts. We're going to have to play a fun game after this. I'll have to think of something. Replay a story option is now available. Alright, guys, that was What Remains of Edith Finch. A beautiful story. Depressing as hell. This was MST3KNJ on YouTube. That's my YouTube channel. Got a ton of LPs. None of them are this fucking depressing, I promise. And hopefully tomorrow or a couple nights down the road, we'll stream something that won't make us all sad and cry and depressed. Thank you for watching, everybody. Appreciate the hell out of it. Have a good night, y'all.